Hi, welcome to another episode of Then We Eat. On today's episode, we'll be making salsa verde. So the first thing we're gonna do is we need to roast our tomatillos. And these are tomatillos that we grew in our garden. We've got lots out there, so we thought we would turn it into the salsa verde. So they're just going to go on a pan with some parchment paper on it for roasting. To that, we're going to add one Then We Eat devil pepper. I'm going to cut the green off and split it in half and put the seeds in and all. And four cloves of garlic. I'm not going to peel it. I'm just going to roast it as it is. We'll peel it when it comes out of the oven. Just a quick note, I've added the parchment paper so that it doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan and it's easier to clean up. So we're going to roast that in a 425 degree oven for approximately 15 to 20 minutes until the tomatillos are nice and soft. So we'll put that in the oven and we'll see you once it's cooked. Okay, and we're back. Our tomatillos are nicely brown and everything is ready to go into the blender. So these are my tomatillos. I'm gonna throw everything in the blender. I'm gonna take the garlic out, take the skins off, and then they'll go in. So those are the tomatillos and the Then We Eat devil pepper. Garlic clove number one. And when you roast garlic, it's very easy to peel. And it tastes so much better and it smells amazing. And to our blender, we're going to add 1/3 cup of chopped onion. This is white onion. 1/2 cup of flat leaf parsley. This is fresh from our garden. This recipe calls for cilantro. I personally don't like cilantro, so I'm going to use parsley. If you like cilantro, by all means, throw it in. 1 clove of chopped garlic, not roasted. I'm gonna start with 1 tablespoon of freshly squeezed lime juice. We'll add more if the recipe needs it. I'm going to use about 1/2 teaspoon of ground cumin. I'm gonna put in 2/4 teaspoons because my teaspoon fits in the bottle. Approximately 1 teaspoon of salt. I'm using kosher salt. We're going to put the lid on that. We're going to give it a blend until we get to the desired consistency that we're looking for. You're looking for it to be thick, but not too thick. Kind of a salsa consistency. And when you're blending hot food, just be very careful that the lid doesn't come off and burn you. I'm going to use the puree section on my blender. It's going to get noisy. Okay, let's see what we have. Very hot. Okay, so let's see if we've got the desired consistency that we're looking for. That's what it looks like. It's a little runny, but it's not too bad. I think we've got the consistency right. I'm going to let this cool a few minutes before I try it. It's best if you let it cool completely, even overnight before you eat it, because you want to let all the flavors melt together. So I'm just going to give it a few minutes to cool before I taste. We'll be right back. And welcome back. Our salsa has been in the fridge for about 1 hour and it's nicely cooled. So let's give it a try. I think we got the consistency down to where we want it. So let's try it and see what it tastes like. So that consistency is perfect. It fits nicely on the chip. It doesn't run off. I'd say that's a success. Whoa, that's good. Get a nice kick from the devil pepper. The lime juice really comes through. You can taste the cumin. Oh my goodness, that is really good. So that should pretty much do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the like button if you like the video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Hit the notification button to be notified when we upload a new video. We try to upload a new video every Friday at 6 a.m. And let us know down in the comments, what'd you think? Would you make this? Or better yet, what else would you like to see us make? And don't forget, first we cook, then we eat. So good.